What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today is a beautiful day because we are going to be going over my top 5 underrated music video effects. We're going to start out with some more beginner level effects, and as we get deeper into the video, the last 2 or 3 effects are a little bit more advanced. So first thing I should mention is that I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro, and we will be using Adobe After Effects as well, which is part of the Creative Cloud. So this first effect we're going to cover today is basically just a flash transition. There are a lot of people who get flash transitions confused with additive dissolves in Adobe Premiere Pro, which if we take in additive dissolve under our transitions, you can see when we go to the middle, it's like this cross dissolve. In order to make like a flash transition, what we need to do, determine where we want the flash to happen. So let's go ahead and zoom in here on this clip for an example, and let's figure out where we want this flash to happen. So right there on that kick right here, you can see it kind of hit. So we want the flash to kind of be right in the middle there. So we're gonna cut this top clip, and obviously we have the next clip underneath, so let's check it out. Go back to where we want the flash to occur, right on that cut. We're gonna go 3 frames to the left, 1, 2, 3. We're gonna cut this first clip up here, and then we're gonna go back 6 frames, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're gonna cut this clip underneath. So we can basically delete that excess underneath right there, take these 2 clips. So what we're gonna do is go right where that cut is made, highlight both clips and hit nest. This creates one main clip out of both of them. And then what I like to do is go to Luma Corrector right here, place that on the clip, and we're gonna go ahead and make keyframes with all of these and basically just start customizing how we want this flash to look. I like using the gain, the pedestal, and the gamma. As you can see, we still have a little bit of detail here. And then if we go to the left 3 frames, 1, 2, 3, we're now at the very beginning, and we're gonna go ahead and just hit the reset button on all of these so it goes back to normal. And now if we tab over, we can see the flash happening. And then I like to go maybe 2 frames after the biggest part of the flash and just reset the keyframes again. So it just very briefly is a flash. So let's check out what that looks like in full motion. When you compare that to the additive dissolve, which is kind of like the default flash transition, or maybe even a dip to white, let's try the dip to white. You can see it's a little bit more flat, not as nice looking, and then the additive dissolve is just kind of different. It's a little weird. So when you compare the additive dissolve to actually making a flash transition using a Luma corrector, there's a huge difference. The next effect is a little bit simple as well. It's well known in music video edits and gaming edits as a good effect. It's called Invert, and you can find this effect directly in Adobe Premiere Pro. Watch these clips right here and you'll see where the invert happens. Young and I'm gonna like tattoos and rollies. Everyone would never go touching the police. Part of the life. As you can see, the colors right here change. We can also change this effect to look more bright if we do luminance. I really like this one. All you need to do to get this effect is go to your effects tab and go to invert under channel. You're gonna drag that over, and by default it's just gonna show up like this. Now there's a bunch of different looks you can get on here with this effect. It can be really bright, really shiny, or if you do quadrature chrominance, it's a little bit more muted. It's more like applying a LUT. And especially when there's like hits happening in the song, it can really add some flair to the edit. So watch it again with this invert on. So you can see right there, it just kind of hits on the bass a little bit harder. Now, another thing you got to realize with these clips right here is this one starts out as the scale with 100, and then it punches in to 122 on the next clip. As it's inverting, it's also punched in as well. So if we watch it, you can see it punches into him, it scales into him, which gives it a little bit more of that slap that we like. So the next effect I'm gonna cover is a little bit more advanced, and you're basically taking a clip and making it black and white and then painting with color on top of it. All the chorus fast and 5% tinted. In order to get this black and white effect, this example clip's already picked out. I already put Lumetri color on it. You can find Lumetri color by going to your effects tab and typing in Lumetri color. And then in Lumetri color, I turn the saturation down to 0 and the contrast up to 50, which gives it that black and white look. Now what you can do once it's black and white. And this is what I did for this effect as well. You'll notice that it's a little bit choppier. The frame rate is actually slowed down. It looks like it's lagging almost a little bit. So check this out. In order to get that lag effect, what we need to do is just find a spot here where we want it to start happening. Let's just take the first clip of him like this. We'll get rid of the Lumetri color on that very first clip. So this is just the part that's black and white. So you can't help me spend it. And then it'll go right back to color right here. So we'll take that black and white off again. So it goes from color to black and white to color. So now that we have this part of the clip cut out and it's black and white, what we need to do now is look up an effect called posterized time, which you can find in your effects tab. Now what this can do is change the frame rate of any video clip and make it like look laggy or, you know, choppy. So what we're gonna do is just slow it down to like 17, and you're gonna see what I'm talking about here. So you can't help me spend it. So you see how that gets a little choppy right there. Then what I like to do is I like to right click on this and hit replace with After Effects composition. And as you can see, it brings it right into After Effects. And what we can do here is duplicate that layer, come up here to paint, the paintbrush right here. Now I already have it set to red and 3 frames in duration. And all we need to do is double click and just start painting lines around his fingers, that sort of thing. You know, we can get really creative, we can go really in depth with it, or we don't have to, we can just do scribbles. And then, you know, you can hit 2 on your keys to tab over to the next frame. And, you know, you're just animating, you know, all these little lines. You know, obviously I'm not spending a lot of time like making the lines really good, so I'm just kind of scribbling on here. But you'll see what it looks like when I play it back in full motion, and you'll see how it adds like a lot of flair to the video. And what I really like about this effect is that you're using color on a black and white image, and the red color on the black and white really pops. Now there's plenty of other colors that would pop out on black and white too. I'm not saying red's the only color, but I do like it for this example. So we'll just finish up here with this last frame. So this will be our last frame. What we can do now is, because we're painting on this top layer, if we come to composition, obviously we're back and we see both of these on our composition. What we can do with this top layer where we painted, we can say paint on transparent right here under the effects tab. So what this is gonna do is, now if we hide our bottom layer, it's only gonna show us the paint that we just painted. So the paint is now on its own layer. And what you can do now that it's on its own layer is you can come up to effects and presets and type in glow and apply this glow, which makes the red pop a lot more. Now I do like to tweak the glow on a transparent background. It's a lot easier to see what's actually happening versus trying to do it with the background. But then when you turn the background back on, you can see right here that it all applies. So when we play it back, you get that effect, which is really cool. And then I can just hit save, and then we can hop right back into Adobe Premiere Pro. And you'll notice here, it just goes right back into Adobe Premiere Pro. And that's what I love so much about the Adobe suite, is that it all links together. I can go from Premiere Pro to After Effects back to Premiere Pro. That is just so powerful alone, and it's so seamless to be able to do it. Now, if you do have issues where you do hop back into Premiere Pro and it's not running smoothly, just render out of After Effects and drag those MOV files into Premiere Pro, and you should be good. That is my third effect, so you can't help me spend it. Which, you know, I really enjoyed. So you can't help me spend it. Fourth underrated music video effect in my eyes is Saber Transitions. So if you go to my website homepage, you can actually go up here to shop. When you click on shop, you can come down to Saber Transitions right here. You can see right here in the header what Saber Transitions are and how they work on your footage. And then you can even try it out for free before you purchase the whole pack. And you can actually watch this video on my website that explains how to use them. And you can see here kind of all the different ones that are included in the pack. And now this pack will work on most editing software as well. It's just a matte transition with a Saber line on top. Now let me show you what I mean by that. So when we go back into Premiere Pro, I already have this example set up here. So you can see this clip is our top clip, and then we have this clip on the bottom. Now I use these same Saber transitions to transition from this top clip to the bottom clip. Check it out. So there's our top clip, here comes the transition, boom. Now these transitions are really fresh. I really love how these turned out. It took me a long time to make these transitions, what you need to do is you need to take a two clips, you know, our first clip that we're transitioning from right here on top, and it's gonna go over top of this clip that we're transitioning to on the bottom. So what I need to do is I need to go and I need to basically just find a Saber transition that I like. Now I have a bunch of Saber transition files from when I made the pack, but I'm just gonna go ahead and use the free Saber transitions right here, which you can download for absolutely free on my website. Wanna try it out, go right ahead, I'll include a link below. In this pack, you're gonna see these lines and the Luma masks. I got a walkthrough guide and a tutorial included in the pack, so hopefully that clears up any confusion if you download it. Basically, all you need to do is take the line that you want. So I'm just gonna use line 7 for this. I'm gonna drag it into my timeline right there. And then I'm gonna go to my Luma mask 7 because it's the same, matches up with the line, and now we can see we have the Luma mask right here and the line on top. So what I'm gonna do now is just drag this clip underneath all the way out. Now we can't see it yet, it's not appearing, so what we need to do is go to our effects tab, type in track matte key right here and drag it onto that clip, change the matte to video 3, which is this layer that has the Luma mask on it. And now we need to change the matte alpha to matte Luma. And then boom, you can see the transition work seamlessly. Now this is a really cool way to transition in music video edits, gaming edits, all that sort of thing. Now the really cool thing about this pack is with these lines that are included is they all have different colors to start, just because I thought the colors were cool. But what you can do is come into Adobe Premiere Pro, go to your effects tab and type in HLS, color balance HLS, drag it onto your line, and you can actually change the color of the line to whatever color you want, which is so dope in my opinion. It's really easy to customize. Check out some of these Saber transitions on my website. I use them for so many things, for YouTube edits, obviously music videos, for gaming videos, all sorts of stuff, for ads. It doesn't matter. These Saber transitions are my baby. I spent a lot of time making them and I tried to make them as practical as I could so that people who are doing all kinds of creative edits will find transitions in the pack that will work amazing for their projects. So definitely check it out on VennerVisuals.com if you're interested. And let's go ahead and move on to the fifth and final music video effect. So the fifth and final music video effect we're going to be looking at is a combination of rotoscoping, cross dissolving, and using turbulent displace in After Effects. We're going to go ahead and take a look at an example of how all these effects can be used together to create a very quick, seamless transition. So check out this example. So if you notice it right here, it's not that noticeable, guys. I mean, it's really quick, but it's so quick and fast and smooth that people watching are like, wow, that was really cool transition. So check this out. If I just scroll over tab by tab, you can see we got him cut out from the background, so the background's not blurry, and he's getting blurry, and then the background cross dissolves just for a second, and then he's blurring over here. And then he blurs right over here. So when that all looks fast motion, it looks like he's kind of just like zooming over to the other side. But in reality, these are two separate takes and it's just a really quick, easy way to make a sick transition. So check this out, full motion one more time. I'm gonna go ahead and recreate this effect from scratch. So we're gonna go ahead and decide how many frames we want the artist to be blurring for. And I usually suggest that you do this effect in like 4 to 5 frames. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4 right here, the rotoscope that we're about to do. And we're gonna make a cut. So we have the last 4 frames of this first clip cut out, right? And then we have the first 4 frames of the next clip cut out. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, so we have 4 and 4, and we're gonna drag both those up. Now we're gonna drag both of these original clips next to each other here on the bottom. We're gonna put a cross dissolve on those, just like that. We're gonna make it really short, just like that. And then what we're gonna do is just highlight both of those clips on top, right click, hit nest, hit okay, and then we're gonna right click again and hit replace with After Effects composition. So now we have both those clips in our nested sequence right here. So what we need to do is we need to come up here to our roto brush and we just need to trace him. And obviously you can spend a lot of time tracing and making this as good or as not good as you want. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm not gonna spend too much time tracing him. So as you can see, we're just kind of jumping around here. I'm gonna trace his arm a little bit. You know, obviously there's some edges that need cleaning up, but for the sake of this tutorial, it's all good. Still gonna be probably a little ugly because I'm not spending a whole lot of time, but yeah, you get the point. So we're cutting him out of the background. We're basically putting him on a layer of his own. So he's gonna be basically resting on the layer above the original backgrounds. So when we go back into After Effects, now that we have him cut out, we can go to an effect called Turbulent Displace. Go ahead and place that on the layer. Switch it from turbulent to horizontal. Switch the size to very small. I would suggest going somewhere under 10 and maybe increasing the amount too. So it's like that. You maybe even go a little smaller like that. So I have a size 2 and a 696 amount. And this is basically how blurry he's gonna get. So right as the transition is happening right here, we want him to be like the most blurry. So we're just gonna make him the most blurry right there. And we're gonna keyframe the size, the amount, and the complexity. Now we're gonna go all the way back to the beginning and we're gonna change him back to the original. So we're just gonna go 0, 0, 0. So now he's cut out with no blur and then he blurs. And then we're gonna go all the way to the end and we're gonna change those to 0 as well. So he gets really blurry for a second and then he's back to normal. When we play that back, it's really quick. Obviously, you can play around with how long or how short you want this effect to last. So we'll go ahead and hit save there. Now when we come back into Premiere, you see we have the effect working. So when I hit play, you can see there, it's just that subtle effect. It's a beautiful combination of cross dissolve with the backgrounds. You can see the cross dissolve happening there. And then turbulent displace and rotoscoping in After Effects. And it's just that subtle effect. And you guys who have been watching my videos knows I love those like subtle, quick effects, those transitions that are noticeable but won't distract viewers from the music, won't distract viewers from the artist, but will still create some style in the edit itself. So I hope these effects helped some of you guys out there. Play around with them, experiment. If you guys have any questions at all, make sure to comment them down below. And if you guys are interested, like I said, in trying out some free Saber transitions or some other free stuff, check out my website. I got plenty of transitions on there, overlays, all the sorts of stuff to help you with your music videos and your gaming videos and your creative edits. So definitely check out venturevisuals.com. I use a lot of that stuff on my own projects and I take a lot of pride in the quality of my packs that I have on there. So definitely check those out if you're interested. I really appreciate everybody for tuning in, and I'm hoping to do some more videos here soon. So make sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for more. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.